Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Kavinsky's Tutorials. I want to take a quick look at Salome by Bram Bos. So I'm not going to do a full walkthrough of the app or anything, it's been out for a while already. So I'm sure that most people have probably already watched something on it. What I do want to look at is the really, really cool, and I mean really cool, like honestly, pretty game-changing new features in the latest update. And one of these in particular is just so cool. So like massive hats off to Bram. I'm just so glad because although I loved Salome in the original version, there were a few things, a few limitations that were honestly kind of grating with me a little bit. And these things are now not an issue anymore because of some of the stuff that's been added. So I'm just super happy and grateful to Bram. So I thought I'd make this video. And if this is useful for you as well, by the way, do please give it a thumbs up, everybody. And if you've got the time, write a comment and so on to help with the algorithm. Thank you very much. So the first thing that's been added is this grid view. And this is just so good in various ways. And we'll look at it in a little bit more detail in a minute. And then the other thing that's been added, if we look up here, it looks almost the same as in the original version. But we can see now that we can toggle some of these modulation knobs to determine whether they are related to, excuse me, X movements, right? So left or right movements, or Y axis movements, vertical movements. And particularly being able to directly control filter cutoff with Y axis movements is really a huge thing for me as someone who's used to say things like the Seaboard, using that with Equator, for example. The way that a lot of the patches are set up is that y-axis movements modulate filter cutoff, and I really like that. And it was kind of a bit weird for me that I didn't have that option in the original version, so I'm really, really loving having it. So let's just quickly look at those then in this video. Now, first we'll look at the sexiest thing, so the grid view. And so first, I just want to mention, in the original view, there were a few limitations that started to bug me a bit the more I was using the app. So, I mean, one thing was just having, 12 notes here. I mean, if you think about any hardware keyboard, even if it's just a 2-octave keyboard, for example, it would never just have 24 notes. It would nearly always have 25 notes, right? Because most people play in C. It's by far the most common key. And it's really handy to have that extra C note at the top. So, you know, just having the C, you can change the root note, but, you know, you couldn't even play 1 octave up simultaneously. So that was a bit annoying for me. And I mean, it was, you know, you could work around it by using another instance of Salome loaded as a MIDI unit, for example. But it's really nice to now just have it all doable right inside one app. So one thing that I loved about the app, by the way, was this what Bram calls the fader board thing. Okay, so you could drag and, you know, just leave it somewhere and you could see where it had been left, right? And then you could just grab it and drag down on it. But although you could change octaves, right? Like here I can go up an octave, for example, okay? I was not able to play this same note, an E note in this case. I wasn't able to play it up on the next octave. Now, the workaround was, let's say I grab this F, right down near the bottom, for example, and just drag it over here. And now I'm playing an E an octave down. But the problem with this was that if I didn't move my finger, okay, no problem, I could drag it back over here. And I now had an F again. But if I at any time took my finger off it, okay, so I'm going to drag this down. Now I'm removing my finger, and so now if I want to grab this note, it'll suddenly jump back up to an F again. So there were a lot of problems really with using just one instance of this. Again, you could use several, and you know, it wasn't the biggest pain in the arse, but it wasn't ideal for me to have to do that. So now it's a different story altogether. It's absolutely brilliant. So let me just show you two really cool things about this. So let me just grab something in the middle first. So let's just play a note here. So now we're dragging over to the right, and you see this little X thing? You see how it has moved off that central point, right, where it started? So it's now over slightly towards the right. So this has several uses, this little thing. First of all, it's a little visual aid, and it shows me that I have pitched the note up from its original frequency by dragging it, doing a per note pitch bend, right, which we can do with MPE. Note that I've got the pitch bend set up full here. Okay, but what's really cool is that if I now go and drag this, I can drag it, and you see it's behaving differently from what we saw over on this view. It's keeping its pitch. So even if I take my finger off, or if I take the mouse and go, you know, somewhere else, I can come back and I can grab that, and then I can just start dragging it back. So we now have an F again. And if I want, I can keep dragging it down, and I can just leave it there, and then I can go and add another note. And then I can come back to this one, grab it, and again start manipulating the pitch from the exact point that I left it at. This is massive. It really is. Like, I can't understate how big a deal this is. Sorry, I can't overstate it. Now, where you really also notice how cool this is if you think about this, if you think that this, if this was a hardware MPE controller, let's say, you know, an instrument or a Roly C board or anything, okay, these C notes here, because they're at the left edge of the keyboard, you basically just couldn't really bend the pitch downwards. You would only really have the ability to bend the pitch up. Okay, but now with it really just so clever the way Bram has done this. So now that we have this little plus thing that we can, see what we can do, we grab that. This is an unintentional thing. Now, this is one of the problems. It's easy to sometimes accidentally play the note below the one that you want to play when you're trying to get near the bottom. Personally, I would quite like, I don't know, like bigger gaps or something here. But also remember, it's also because I'm trying to use this trackpad, and it's honestly much better to use the finger. So I'm just going to use my finger here now and just leave that. So I'm going to grab this, turn it up a little bit, and now I'm going to start dragging it down. And I'll just show you with the mouse for a minute. So see, what we would get, right, you know, with most setups, including hardware, is it just can't drag down there anymore, okay? But now here we can, because what I do is I just grab it again, and I just keep dragging to the left. I'll show you with the mouse. Okay, I let go and I come back and grab it and drag it down more. And I can just keep going down. So I can still end up with a really low note there. So this is just so good. It really is. Bram, thank you. Honestly, that's a very, very, very nicely done implementation. I hate these trackpads. You know, I'm just trying to move this up here, but for whatever reason, I'm accidentally triggering notes. It's nothing to do with Salome. It's just the way my trackpad is behaving. So now let's take a very quick look at this you know, new stuff up here. So, okay, so remember that when we modulate the filters, for example, here, basically this is going to be like the master filter cutoff, okay? And the way we set things up here will just alter it a little bit. So first, there's just a few things that I'm going to do to make things a little bit clearer over here. So I'm going to disable Y axis modulation of volume by bringing this button down completely. And I'm also going to just completely take down this LFO rate modulation thing. And the tremolo is down already. Pitch bend, I'm going to leave that. Well, no. Yeah, no, let's just take that down as well. So now there's no pitch bend capability anymore. Okay. Filter cutoff. Okay, so at the moment you can see this is assigned to X. So I'm going to change it so it will be assigned to Y. And for now I'm just going to leave it down. And panning, I'm also going to pull that knob down completely. And then cutoff. Cutoff. First of all, I'm going to change the filter type to a low pass filter. And I'll just bring this, I'll just leave that cutoff there actually. I'll bring this resonance down a little bit. I'm just going to make sure this LFO depth and LFO rate are turned down. And over here, let me see. I think I'll just leave it with the fast attack and I'll bring down that release time a bit as well. And let me bring down this filter modulation here. Okay, so now what you'll see is that, so remember now y-axis is not modulating anything. So basically anywhere I play on the y-axis shouldn't matter whether I play at the bottom or top. The cutoff is going to just remain at the same frequency. Sorry, that's very harsh sounding. Hang on. Okay. Right, so look, I'm dragging that around. And it's just staying at the same frequency. So now if I bring this filter cutoff modulation knob up to full, now if I start dragging around here, we should actually hear the filter opening and closing. So you hear that getting brighter there? Right? Okay, so this is great. So I'm not going to go into the other things. I'll just mention one thing. I hope I'm remembering this right. I had a bit of email chat with Bram about this earlier. If I remember right, if you have if the LFO is active, then this modulation knob here, for example, will, you know, this, if we put this up full, then the maximum point it will be able to go to is whatever the maximum point that the LFO goes to. And if the LFO is off, then it'll just go to whatever the maximum value set on the main cutoff knob is. So yeah. So basically, you know, with a low pass filter, if you want this to be brighter, then just, you know, have turned this all the way up. But if you never wanted to get all that bright, then just bring it down a bit. So like here, it will only reach to 50% of the value here. And do bear in mind, of course, that it's all going to behave differently depending on the filter type, right? So now you can control the LFO rate with X modulation or Y modulation. You can control tremolo with those. So let's just see with the Y modulation, for example. Oops, I'm dragging that. wrong direction. Okay, so you see it getting faster there. If I now tap X, so see how it's slowing down when I drag over to the left. Look at the little plus sign. Let me turn it up a bit. Oops. Right? So you get an idea there, I think, of how those things work. So yeah, what a cool update. What a cool update. This has now just become a really, really, really fantastic drone machine. Love it so much. So yeah, the only thing that is still a slight niggle for me is not having any arrows on presets. I don't know. I just hate preset systems that don't have arrows. Mind you, what I usually use is the internal AUM presets, and actually there are no arrows there either. I don't know though. Generally with AUV3 apps, I just always expect there should be arrows in the preset system. But yeah, again, look, honestly, Bram, thank you so much for, you know, listening to people's ideas for how Salome could be improved. I think this is just turning into such a great app. I can really see myself using this a lot. And it's very fairly priced as well, I think, at the price that it came out at. So thank you, Bram. Thank you so much. And thanks, everyone, for watching. And yes, please do, you know, hit the like and so on. If you're feeling generous, remember, it's always great to get donations. I earn, like, such a pittance from YouTube. Okay, everyone. Thanks, and see you soon. And enjoy Salome. Get this new update from the App Store. It's fantastic. Like I said, you know, this is now, in many situations, got some advantages over hardware with this ability to, you know, drag even the leftmost notes down large amounts in pitch. That's a really, really great feature. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. Take it easy.